Hello and welcome to NewsClick. We're going to discuss with D. Raghunandan, who has been following the issue of the aircraft acquisitions that has been going on for quite some years now, which has ended with the 36 Rafale aircraft being bought. There's been now a controversy about it. Congress has raised issues regarding how this has been done, at what price this has been done, and so on. But this has been a matter of controversy for quite some time. Raghu, we have talked about it in NewsClick itself when this 36 aircraft was suddenly decided during Pierre Bode's visit to Paris. And we had said that this seems to be a very startling development considering the long process, the fixing of what our needs were, what kind of aircraft we wanted, and sudden decision to buy 36 of Rafale aircraft, not 126, not transfer of technology. Is there anything which has come out in Nirmala Sitharaman's statement which throws some more light on this?
Unfortunately not. Raksha Mantri has basically said that all procedures were followed in taking this decision. How they were followed, which committee has decided what based on inputs from whom, unknown. So there is complete opacity in this. There's no transparency at all, because every other day, even the Air Force chief, who was somehow pressurized to come out in defense of this Rafale deal, is lamenting the fact that we have got only 36 of these aircraft. We require much more. The squadron strength is highly depleted. India went through a prolonged process of discussion and deliberations. Inputs from all stakeholders, including the user agency, the Indian Air Force, the bureaucracy, and the political leadership, to come to a decision that India required medium weight or twin engined aircraft and required about 126 of these aircraft. In fact, the original tender which India had floated was for multi-role combat aircraft, in which everybody had applied, including the F-16, the Gripen, they're all single-engine fighters, the MiG-35. But then the committee sat down in India and said, no, our requirement based on the IAF's needs and where our Air Force strength is and weaknesses are, we require twin-engined aircraft. Suddenly, this decision was taken not to buy 126, but to buy 36. Nirmala Sitharaman made the point that we did this because our government believes in decisive action, and we took a decision because the Air Force desperately needed some aircraft. But the Air Force says it desperately needs 126 aircraft. So I find this strange, that a system has been set up for defense procurement, keeping the user agency's needs in mind, that seems to have been given the go-by, and now that is being praised as effective decision-making. It may have been quick decision-making, but it has certainly not been effective, and I don't think it keeps India's long-term interests in mind, both in terms of the defense requirements and the requirements of transfer of technology.
You raised the issue of transfer of technology. In this particular case, there is no transfer of technology involved. I think the first time the defense minister has explicitly said no transfer of technology is involved. Is that right?
That's absolutely right. And as you said, this is the first time this has been openly admitted. Those who know the aviation industry would know that if a foreign equipment manufacturer is going to supply 36 aircraft, extremely difficult to transfer technology in the real sense of the word, which is also one of the reasons why India had put forward a requirement of a larger batch of aircraft so that they could be gradually productionized and indigenized in this country. Therefore, what is now going to happen is some component manufacture in India, largely assembly, will take place here. There is still an offset requirement. 50% supposedly of the value is going to be offset in this. But as usual in these offset deals, you will see that the MOU has been signed between the Rafale manufacturer, Dassault Aviation, and Reliance.
Anil Ambani's Reliance.
And Reliance has zero prior experience in aviation. And actually, funnily enough, even very little or no experience in any kind of manufacturing. How a corporation like that expects to enter into any kind of manufacturing role for as sophisticated a piece of engineering as a combat aircraft is completely beyond me. So clearly they are only going to be turning the screwdrivers here. Importantly, the offsets are not going to be within the Rafale deal. Dassault Aviation is going to start sub-assembly or assembly of its Falcon jets, which are civilian jets, and they will show that as offsets. Now, this is achieving only a commercial goal. Some amount of money gets spent in India. But the idea of the offsets was not just to gain money, but to gain technology.
Buying 36 aircraft is going to cost us anything between 60 to 70% of the total 126 aircraft we are negotiating with France earlier. Yes. So it does seem that per aircraft, a cost is roughly 2.5 to 3 times what was originally envisaged. Yes. Now this is again seems to be a very arbitrary decision.
One doesn't know exactly how much these 36 aircraft are going to cost. In her otherwise fairly extensive press conference yesterday, all that Raksha Mantri could promise was that she will make the data available. I'm not sure how much of that is going to happen.
It's almost more than a year since it's
happened. More than a year since it's happened, and there's always confidentiality clauses to hide behind, and that too in defense matters. So with one thing or another, I'm not sure we'll get to know what exactly is involved. But the deal as such, because they are flyaway conditioned aircraft with all kinds of other after-sales service and all promised, and this is precisely the idea of building in more indigenization, is to acquire the capability and to bring down costs. And in this case, you're achieving neither.
So you are locked into a kind of long-term path dependency, as it were.
That's right.
Because anything that you need to be done, you'll have to call Dassault.
And I have a last worry, and that is, India has suddenly started talking about buying a whole lot of single-engined aircraft. We started this discussion saying, how come after India took so long and after a long process of deliberation, arrived at the requirement for twin-engined aircraft and 126 of them, and now suddenly you turn back and revert to single engine aircraft. Even there, given the way the Rafale deal has gone, how do we know they are going to buy 100, 200 with gradual indigenization? Or suddenly, because of emergency requirement, that's also going to end up with 35 or 40 bought out aircraft. I think this is, we are entering into very dangerous territory, very thoughtful procedures of decision making to enable thoughtful planning for acquisitions has been set up, and now you're back to taking arbitrary decisions, which was precisely the reason why those defense procurement procedures were set up in the first place.
You know, one part is corruption, the other is you get what is called the museum of different technologies.
That's right.
That means you get 36 Rafale,
right.
You get some Gripen,
right.
You get some F-16s.
Right.
Now, all of this is mishmash
that's
of
right.
technologies, maintaining them,
right.
dependencies on different kinds of parties, all
Absolutely.
Of it also make you much more vulnerable.
Absolutely.
So, in fact, it was to get out of the Mirage mix that we had, that it was decided we should this time go for
volume.
A larger volume, and as
exactly.
you said, develop indigenous capability. That path has been abandoned. We are back to shopping on a piecemeal basis. Last question on this. India also has its own combat aircraft technology, which has taken considerable period of time to develop. One shouldn't really worry about that because F-35s have taken almost 35 years. So therefore, this is not unknown in the aviation industry. So do you think there is, in fact, a much stronger case for building one or two lines, one of which should be our indigenous capability, technology itself?
100%. Because, as you know, I have long been critical of the slow pace of development of the LCA project. I believed that more resources and more planning should have gone into it to ensure quicker and more effective delivery of the LCA aircraft. India has set up very successful systems to achieve self-reliance in technology in space and in nuclear. And in both these cases, by the way, even though they are very high-tech and the deepest part of the security establishment in this country, we have achieved not only a high extent of indigenization, a lot of the manufacture today is being done by the private sector under subcontracts from either BARC or from ISRO in the nuclear or the space cases. The same thing could have been developed by now for the LCA and can be developed in future also. Right now, Hindustan Aeronautics is saying we can supply only 15 aircraft a year, which is clearly not enough. It is then up to the government to build a system where you can increase production volumes by putting in more money into a decentralized thing, which I'm sure HAL will be happy to take up. And I think that's the route to go, rather than if you today go with an F-16 route or something like that, you're likely to see the LCA go further down the priority line.
Essentially, it is mortgaging our future
unfortunately,
Air Force capabilities to the exigencies, shall we say, of new strategic alliances Mr. Modi is trying to build. Thank you very much, Raghu, for being with us. This is all the time we have today in NewsClick. Please keep watching NewsClick and also visit our YouTube site, our Facebook page.